you. Please be more careful. Just give him a coffee and expect to let somebody tell us, I guess.
So that he gets your brilliant moments, we can then be able to recapture them when we start shooting. We start shooting a week from today, and what's really special is that we get to work in space that we're shooting in. We're going to be in here. This is going to become our space, ours as a team. I want you to make this space your own. Really make it your own. As you'll see behind you, there are these lines, and looking back at my writing, I realize I often think a lot in lines. Not linear, per se, but lines against the wall, lines across a floor, lines across a space, more importantly. And what I want you to explore in your space, what are the lines of your character? Not like these kind of lines, but the kind of lines you would not cross. What would you cross? What line would Jason cross? And what line would you not allow him to cross? Because in this scene we're talking about, you were like an animal possessed. And you see that. You see it. These people that you have devoted your life to have just turned into animals. And so that brings me to my next point. This whole space at some point will be filled with color red. And so as we go into that, especially as we go into those shot sequences, I really want you to think about what the color red means to you. Kind of how it makes you feel, but more importantly, how would you describe the color red to someone who's never seen it before? Another question to ask yourself is, have you seen the color red before?
Miserable am I, and too stubborn. It was all for nothing, raising my children and loving them. Fearing for them, enduring the pains of giving birth. Miserable am I to think that they should love and care for me in my old age.
I'm sorry, I don't know where to stand. I don't know where I'm supposed to be. Where's the camera?
Let's not worry about the camera now. We're still in this exploratory phase. So your decisions are crucial right now. So why don't you make a decision on where you want to stand and stay there?
I'm sorry.
Okay, we're ready to move on. Let's take it from the same place. All right, whenever you're ready.
Miserable am I to think that they should love and care for me in my old age. Dress my dead body. No. No! My enemies shall not go unpunished. My hand shall not be weakened. My children shall never feel the rage of my enemies. Their death is necessary.
Let's hold for a moment. I didn't want really well. Okay. Zora.
Well, I like that you're chosen a spot. It's a strong spot.
I want to ask you though, what was the impulse for that circle?
It's in the script. She begs the gods, so that's what I was doing.
Okay.
It's in the script.
No, I like the impulse. It's just we're feeling beating a dead horse here. We're continuing along with these lines. I think we need to make your character even stronger. And a circle, I think, is weaker than if you made a square. I think you need to make a square. I like your impulse, but I think instead of a circle, you need a square.
You want me to make, to beg the gods, making a...
See, crazily enough, that looks stronger. It reads it stronger.
I'll make a square. This wig is really driving me crazy. I'm sorry, it's just like constantly in my face, and I know you wanted the, you know, old lady crazy look, but this is really out of control. You know, it's
okay.
In my face constantly. It itches and it's just not, you know, it's ridiculous.
Okay, we've taken note. And we'll be taken care of.
Thank you.
Let's move on to the next, shall we? Let's let whatever this is settle, and we will just pick it up from the next scene. So take a moment, whenever you're ready, take it away.
You've killed her. The princess in front of your husband and children.
That devil is no longer my husband.
They'll be coming after you any minute.
I'm thrilled to hear this news.
Thrilled?
Mm.
Are you mad? Aren't you afraid? You've killed that beautiful princess.
Thank you.
with you anymore anyway.
It doesn't matter. They're my clothes, and I don't want you wearing them.
Look how nice it looks on me.
Not today.
When's the last time you wore this, huh? I want the stories that go with this fab ensemble.
Please, I've had the worst day in all of human history.
Really?
Yes, really. Now, that outfit has particular sentimental value.
I thought this was the outfit you wore when you made out with Mickey Rourke. Stories, please.
Not now. Take it off.
It's known to waste, you know.
After my diet, I'll get into that again.
Oh, yeah. The eternal diet.
Watch it.
I love what these clothes do to me. I am Superwoman! I feel like I'm ready to tackle someone. Maybe it's the shoulder pads.
Well, it helped when we were slam dancing.
Right. Slamming into each other. I feel so Cindy Lauper in the go.
Take it easy. That cost me a fortune back in my day.
I bet. It's divine. At least let me borrow it.
No.
What a pill!
You have beautiful clothes.
Why is this such a big deal?
Don't be ridiculous.
Oh, I bet you wore this at Studio 54.
No! Limelight. Or Danceteria. Never mind, now off.
Okay, what happened at rehearsal?
Nothing. It was fabulous. Couldn't have gone better. They worshiped me.
What is it with you?
I'm going to start screaming in a second. Now take my clothes off your body, or I will take them off you myself.
Okay, take it easy. Get a grip. I thought you'd like it. I thought it would make you happy that these clothes that have been hanging in your closet for years now would finally get used. I thought you would like to see me wear them. They fit me great. Meant for me. Why do you keep them anyway?
I'm getting into that outfit again.
Why would you want to? They're not meant for.
For what?
They're just very youthful, that's all.
What's that smell?
She noticed. Yes.
I don't know, something.
Something really rad. Out of this world. Lentils seasoned with honey, bay leaf, sea salt, pomegranates, and drizzled with olive oil. Octopus cooked in beer and seasoned with thyme, garlic, and leeks. Beef liver simmered in pureed chestnuts, honey, figs, and crushed coriander seed. And a rabbit stewed with leeks, slowly seasoned with bay leaf, and honey made from bees that were fed thyme. The result is a fragrance you won't believe. Only I expected you hours ago. I hope it's not all ruined.
What is all of this?
It's for your film. To get you in the mood for Medea. The tastes of ancient Greece. I've been researching for weeks. We're having a special meal for a special night.
I'm not
here. I want you to drink this.
I'm not in the mood for a special night.
Well, you're gonna have one whether you like it or not.
Is this a plot to keep me gaining weight so that you can take all my clothes?
Eleusis, baby. That's where we're headed to tonight.
Eleusis.
It means the place of happy arrival. The Eleusin mysteries were practiced by Aristotle and Plato and all those ancient Greek playwrights. Even your dear Euripides. The mysteries were founded in ancient Minoan Crete.
Minoan, your enthusiasm for this is too much for me right now.
The Minoans were that incredible, super evolved culture that lasted nearly 2,000 years. They predated the Mycenaeans and the ancient Greeks.
What is this mystery thing?
What? No one really knows, but we are recreating it tonight.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Pay attention. The drink you're about to have is from an ancient recipe from the magical land of Crete. It's balneotherapy, called 40 herbs. This sublime recipe has been passed down for millennia, 4,000 years to be exact. In this cup is a living poem. I boiled those special herbs in a clay pot that has never been used before. For the Minoans and for those of Crete, even today, this drink is how they they remember their songs and dances and poems. The babies from Crete are bathed in this when they are born, so they remember who they are.
I'm going to remember who I am. Drink, please. It smells incredible. Taste.
Aged man is but a paltry thing, a tattered coat upon a stick.
There's a suitcase out here.
Yes, there is.
What's that doing there?
I'm leaving.
Not today.
I told you.
No, you didn't.
We had this conversation last week, remember? I told you it was time for me to go.
You're not leaving tonight.
Yes, I am.
Why?
It's just time, it's all.
You're not leaving.
Yes, I am.
What is that?
Not that surprise.
It's not acting anything. What are you wearing? What is going on around
here? We talked about this, and I'm not changing my mind. This is all part of the surprise.
I told you.
I don't want surprises.
And I certainly won't let you go.
Won't let me go, really. You don't own me, you know.
You said you would stay here until after we finish the spell.
I did not.
Yes, you did. You said you would help me through this. I distinctly remember. You told me you'd wait.
That was the last way.
I depend on you. This is a very difficult process.
You don't need my help.
Yes, I do. You're very important to me. Please, you manage everything, my life, my work. You can't just up and leave, not now.
Really? I don't think you have much of a choice.
I'm lost without you. You're my communicator, my shrink, my cop.
My lawyer, my sister, my mother.
My friend.
Daughter. Anything but that.
This is a very bad moment for you not to be here.
I know. I know I'm all those things for you, but I'm not myself. You're on your own after.
Everything is conspiring to make me want to jump out a window today.
Don't do that.
Do what?
Don't threaten me with your drama.
I'm not threatening. It's just, it's too much for me. This film is tearing me apart. I need you here right now. At least stay a little while longer until after the shoot is over.
And then it'll be after the next gig, and then after that.
No, I won't do that.
I really mean it now. I'm going tonight.
Talk about it later.
No, we won't.
You can have my clothes if you want.
I have things to do, you know. When I'm here, the world revolves around you. I'm locked up here. I need to have a life. I'm important too.
What are you going to do? You need me as much as I need you. It's happened before.
I'll figure it out.
You've forgotten how difficult it is out there. Here you have a beautiful home, food, terrific, now Grecian clothes.
After tonight, I'm gone.
I'm afraid for you. At least stay here long enough to know that you can do it. Be on your own without falling into old habits.
I'm beyond that. I'm different now. I feel confident, sure of myself.
No doubts?
No.
Agonizing, paralyzing fears.
Be honest with yourself.
Are you ready?
Why are you doing this?
I don't want you to get hurt again. I am here, have always been here to help.
It's not going to work.
Let's just talk about this later.
No way, you're not getting away with this.
Your face, it crinkles up. Always has when you get passionate about something, even as a baby. You kind of look like a walrus, a constipated one, a CDF.
I'm not putting this off any longer. I love you. I love you very much. But I have to do this. After tonight, I'm gone. and there's nothing you can say that will change that. And when I walk out that door, I don't want any drama. Save it for Medea.
Medea?
What?
I heard that Zoe Caldwell called her Medea, not Medea. She said that was the correct way to pronounce the name.
Medea.
I like it.
Mystery night for Medea. Wait till you see what I have planned.
How about a little appreciation here? It would be really nice to hear thank you for slaving in the kitchen all day to make a special meal before you leave and go away as you said you would so many times, but I kept you from doing that.
You're not going anywhere.
God, you're infuriating!
Yes, I am. You tried me.
Lioness with new cubs at anyone who comes near and offers any suggestion.
You'd be right to conclude that the people of olden times were stupid and lacking wisdom when they invented poems. Since no one has been able to end our agonizing griefs with poetic powers. Women of Corinth, I have come outside to show you that you have no cause to tarnish me with blame. People are unjust. They hate on sight before they've gotten to know a person. Foreigners should be especially careful to fit in the society they join. The circumstances that have befallen me have ravaged my spirit. My be-all and end-all has turned out to be the lowest of the low. My husband. We women are hunted by misfortune more than any other species. First, we have to buy our very expensive husbands, and then we have to accept them as masters of our body. And it's a throw of the dice whether he's good or bad to us.
They men allege that we enjoy a life secure from danger, safe at home, while they confront the thrusting spears of war. I'd rather join the ranks of battles 3 times than give birth but once.
Interesting. Did you just say that?
I'm not like you. I have lost my people, my family. I am citizenless, deserted, humiliated, thrown around like a sack, with no one willing to offer me safe harbor. I am a refuge from apocalypse. And so I ask this one thing of you. If I can get revenge for my husband's wrongs, please stay silent. When a woman has been wrongly treated in the field of sex, there is no cast of mind more deadly. None.
Those are Medea's lines. We have to run yours.
I can't.
Zora.
I can't. Be thank you. Say the same. Be away with that scene. Horis afti, then that you missed on your own.
Where were you today?
The ocean. I needed the ocean. I went for a swim. Rehearsal was a disaster.
I'm sure it was fine. You always been
such a no. This was pretty bad. I had the strangest thing happen to me today.
I was sitting at a beach cafe, watching the young mothers and their children and the waves.
I suddenly thought of this friend from elementary school who had died, Celia. She'd fallen off the fourth floor balcony of her parents' apartment. Horrible. Freak accident. It was such a shock to us kids. Sixth grade. Such a delicate age. So much going on. Boy and girl parties. Everyone liked her. She sat next to me in school. One day our teacher, Mrs. Boris, she had us make these paper flowers, and then she waited behind her desk while we came up to her one at a time to get a special final magical touch. It was all this big secret until it was our turn. When I went up, she took my paper flower, hid it beneath her desk, and dabbed on the petal some of her 40s red, sweet-smelling lipstick. That boring paper came to life. Anyway, mine got trampled on by one of the wild boys, Devin, and Santa gave me hers. It felt so odd and empty in the classroom when she was gone. That was my first encounter with death. The first time I felt death's presence. She was very close to me today. I was sitting at the cafe licking my wounds after rehearsal. And suddenly I thought of Sandy, and right at that moment, a toddler moved away from her mother and towards the play structure next to her. It started saying, Celia! Celia! interested in your woo-woo loca spiritual explanation for something that was just an amazing coincidence.
Okay.
I can't seem to find my place. Who I am. I know who I was, but now, this is all new to me. At rehearsal today, I didn't know where to stand, what to do with my hands. Like I was a kid just starting out. A mess of music and fire, that's me. You disapprove of me when I talk like this, don't you?
Not exactly. Though I wish I understood you better.
When you do, will you let me in on it? This is just part of your process. No, this is different. They have me in this ridiculous white wig, and I'm off to the side like an appendage, a sixth finger. They don't need me. They just want some moving statue, a hollow robot of some old broad. The only reason I got the part was because of Sophia. Her mother and I came up together.
Lunch, right? We got the Academy Award.
Yes, for some reason, Sophia's followed my work.
Of course she has. Why are you belittling yourself?
This role is an embarrassment.
You can be great at this. It's a beautiful role.
God, I hate this play.
It's one of the great plays, Zora.
Oh, please, it won third prize back in the day. And the only reason it was received so well is because Medea's a foreigner. If Euripides had made her a Greek woman, it never would have been accepted, let alone win an award.
That is ridiculous.
It's absolutely true. So you have this woman who kills her children. No one wants to sit for hours with someone capable of that. You go with it because she's a foreigner.
And, foreigners are different.
She was betrayed. Everyone can relate to that.
Yeah. Getting furious, yes. Stealing the car, the home, the money, absolutely. But killed the children. I can't bear the thought of it.
I bet you could kill me.
Please.
Given the right circumstances.
Not a chance. And no woman in her right mind would.
So she's crazy?
Yes, but we never see her as crazy. No one ever plays her that way.
The most dear little ones. Now you sound like the nurse.
Traitor.
You're doing that thing where you play a role and you start thinking and feeling just like the character.
Oh.
The nurse feels the way you do right now.
Ridiculous and wrong.
I got you.
I hate this director. I hate the set.
Nice deflection. And by the way, he's a very respected young director. You were dying to work with him.
Yes, until today. It almost makes me think someone else directed that beautiful film we saw. What was it called?
Out of the Woods.
Now that was fantastic. Why can't he
make the same film again? Everyone we know loves him.
Gonyo, he's such a fraud. And he's all but 10 years old. He looks at me with this condescending, annoyingly passive-aggressive face.
Are you sure you're not the one being condescending and annoying?
I'm supposed to get slapped. So humiliated. It's because of my age and that I'm a woman that they think they can get away with it.
What's wrong with getting slapped? There's nothing humiliating about it. You're on stage, for Christ's sake. It has nothing to do with being a woman. You're not a woman anymore anyway. You're a beautiful woman, I was kidding. Actresses get slapped. It's a tradition.
Traditions can change.
Don't say you hate Sophia Ray, she's an amazing actress.
She's very nice.
She's fantastic. I can't believe you don't get her.
What's there to get? There's nothing there yet.
Also, for an actress to be interesting or have something there, as you say, she has to be old.
I prefer the word seasoned.
Okay then, seasoned.
She's just young.
And cool and fantastic, and she is making some really interesting films.
She's barely 21. I mean, how much younger is this Jason character going for? What is this director doing? He has this gorgeous, very young woman being left for an even younger woman? I mean, really, please. Not even in ancient Greece.
I know what you're thinking.
What am I thinking, smarty pants?
I wonder what you think the casting should be.
Sophia should be playing the young bride, and I should be playing Medea.
I knew it.
What?
Sophia played the bride, and you're playing Medea. And who, the girl playing the young bride now?
She's out of a job.
And who plays the nurse?
actual old woman who doesn't need a white wig. What? It's traditional. It's the traditional way of doing the play.
But didn't you say traditions can change? And he's not doing a play, it's a film. It's an experimental film.
Oh, please. His film after Out of the Woods was that big budget feature, Crush the Invaders. Out of the Woods probably had nothing to do with him. I should have known it was a fluke. It was all the performers and a great DP. Crush the Invaders was not exactly an experimental film.
Well, maybe he made that one so he could do this one.
It just doesn't make any sense. I could really do something with that role. In the hands of a child, it's absurd, it's meaningless, it's just wrong.
You're too old for that role.
I'm sorry. No, you're not.
I'm just saying that maybe 10 years ago, but...
You better stop.
It's just a fact of life. I didn't mean to hurt you.
That landed exactly where you wanted it to.
I'm sorry.
Where's dinner?
Probably gonna be all dried up and terrible,
said the director to the old actress.
This is not like you.
What's me?
What?
Who am I supposed to be? I'm very disappointed in you. Dealt with a lot of harshness, downright cruelty today. I hoped that it would be easier here at home with you.
I'll get dinner.
She's very alien to me. You know, I prayed that I would have something to say that would make sense. I somehow seem to have lost the reality of the reality. I dream funny dreams. I'm not myself. This woman you are playing is as helpless as you are, as helpless as I am. She wants to fall in love, but her time has passed. You understand that, don't you? How old are you? You see, it's too late. Just please tell me what this play doesn't express. Hope. What is this?
What?
This picture.
Oh, that was a surprise. Don't you remember, Toby? From that time we went to Santa Barbara and stayed at that hotel, you know, that had that great herb garden right outside our window. You know, when we saw that group of dolphins do that incredible dance-like show like we were at SeaWorld or something.
I vaguely remember the dolphins.
Toby. You have to remember Toby. He was so cute. Met us a bonfire at the beach one night. We sang carol king songs.
Really? You don't remember him?
I saw him. He was so great to out of nowhere run into him like that. You know, to see someone you connected with but didn't think you'd ever see again, and then poof, there was Toby. Like no time had passed at all. It had been, I don't know, 5 years or something? He saw me and came running. mysteries. This raki is ambrosia from the gods.
Did you know that Jason and Medea went to Crete after she helped him win the Golden Fleece?
Come on, step out of it and get into it with me.
Are you going to see him again?
Who?
Toby. Probably not.
It was fun, but
you're a free spirit.
You got that right.
Your own woman.
Absolutely. I got an image of myself in a store window today. The wind was blowing and my hair was loose and free. I could tell something extraordinary was going to happen. Like the wind was conspiring to make something wonderful appear. A surprise.
A special gift sent my way. This time it was Toby.
From one day to the next, I feel like there's always something wondrous waiting for me. Like I have these secret angels, unseen hands guiding and helping me. I feel like I can just spread my wings and take off right now.
You sound demented.
Ooh. You think? Dear delicious Toby.
Can you smell him?
Don't be crude.
Are you sure you don't remember him?
Don't ask me that again.
He just seems so strange.
What are you insinuating? That I'm losing my mind? That I'm going senile? He just wasn't memorable. That's all.
uncomfortable for me as well. These situations don't get easier with time. Not even with a time machine. I can't. I'm sorry, I have to get back to work.
20 years of this. I know you. By 4 a.m. you'll be answering the door, he'll be on the other side, and you'll let him in. The next day you feel awful and lost and forgotten.
You have no idea.
You blew it a long time ago.
Don't be cruel.
You can't make it better, Zora. It's too late.
Get off my back.
You were so excited to get the flowers. You didn't notice who they were for.
He sent them to me.
How did you...
You switched. I didn't do anything.
Wait a second, that card was here.
Really? You're gonna pretend you don't know?
Know what? What's happened?
Wake up.
It was always you. He came here because he was looking for you.
How old are you? Really? I'm trying to be patient here. How old are you? I'm 55. How old are you? If you can't say your age, then you can't accept the blame.
I'm not your age.
What is your age?
I admit that playing an older woman is part of the problem.
I have no illusions about being a teenager.
I accept my age. I'm just not ready to play grandmothers yet. If I'm good at this part, my career is severely limited.
Limited to what?
Once you're convincing in a role, the audience accepts that.
As what?
As old.
Are you going to quit?
No. I'm going to play this part where age doesn't make any difference. Age isn't interesting. Age is depressing. Age is dull. Age doesn't have anything to do with anything. You know, I don't have a family. Or a husband. This is it for me. I get my kicks out of acting. If I can reach a woman in the audience who thinks that no one understands, and that my character is going through everything that she is.
And the aged man is but a paltry thing, a tattered coat upon a stick.
Why are you doing this? Why are you all conspiring to destroy me?
There's no conspiracy
you
here, Zora.
You deliberately kept me in the dark, made me think that I was watching.
I have no secrets from you.
I'm not made of stone.
All you ever wanted was the stage, to be an actress. This life is exactly what you wished for, what you chose.
No!
You work constantly, you love your work. People see you on stage and love you. Wake up!
This isn't what I wanted. You couldn't possibly understand because you have a wide open horizon ahead of you. But for me, it's all closing in. I'm being treated like a dog, like an old witch that has to be pushed to the side and mocked.
Like a useless, worn out doll. You're being an older, not an elder, and I'm sick of it.
Oh. When I was young, I had everything. I felt so powerful. I could do anything and know that I was being loved and watched and wanted. I could turn my head anywhere and catch adoring eyes, lustful eyes on me. Now I'm not even here. I'm invisible. I walk into a room and no one even notices. A ghost of who I was. Why is this happening? I don't feel any different, so why do I look so different? Why am I even talking to you about this?
You couldn't possibly understand. Yes, I can. Don't be ridiculous. Stop speaking my words.
It's the neurons.
What?
Our neurons are the same from the moment we're born for the rest of our lives. Our bodies on the cellular level completely change every 2 weeks, so we are the same and constantly changing.
Oh, please, what is that? You dole out wisdom like you know something, like you've lived long enough to know anything at all.
You never felt that powerful, Zora.
Yes, I did.
Impossible.
How would you know how I felt?
You know very well how I know.
Open your eyes already. I'm quitting.
You can't quit.
Why?
It's not in the cards. You are ruthless. You don't quit, Zora.
Well, I'm quitting now.
No, you won't.
An aged man is but a paltry thing, a tattered coat upon a stick.
You won't quit because that's not what you do. Because you've been cast. Because you're an actress and you take what you're offered. Because you're bigger than you think you are.
These are bullshit cards that we are dealt. This age thing, this growing old sentence, because that's exactly what it is, a sentence that we can't be reprieved of no matter what. It's wrong to grow old, to see death coming closer, to know that we will take our final breath. I can't bear it. It torments me. I've seen people die and it's horrible. This is cruel and unfair, and whoever, whatever, made this our human condition. Our reality is a son of a bitch.
I didn't ask for this part. Stop doing that. Stop speaking my words.
Zora, they are my words.
I've been holding you up, putting you before everything my entire life. You have always called the shots. You are a tyrant.
Heck.
Sophia, holy wisdom. ever fought this battle and won. You are stuck in the mire and missing the sky. Sempre tengas al corre de alítica. Hasta arribari, es el teo destino. Pero no forces gens la travesía. Es preferible que duri both signs. That's lovely. Soothing. What is it? Something our ancestors sang. What does it mean? When you set out on your journey to Ithaca, pray that the road is long, full of adventure, full of knowledge. Pray that the road is long, that the summer mornings are many, when, with such pleasure, with such joy, you will enter port scene for the first time. Stop at Venetian markets and purchase fine merchandise. Mother of pearl and coral, amber and ebony, and sensual perfumes of all kinds, as many sensual perfumes as you can. Visit many Egyptian cities to learn and learn from scholars. Always keep Ithaca in your mind. To arrive there is your ultimate goal. But do not hurry the voyage at all. It is better to let it last for many years and to anchor at the island when you are old, rich with all you have gained on the way, not expecting that Ithaca had offered you riches. Ithaca has given you the beautiful voyage. Without her, you would have never set out on the road. She has nothing more to give you. And if you find her poor, Ithaca has not deceived you. Wise as you have become with so much experience, you must have already understood what Ithaca's
would like to stay and join us for that.
Great.
Thank you.
Bye.
Chibas.
Hearing you next, Marissa, talk about how long she's been working on it.
understand the journey. I mean, you do that in any play, be it as abstract or as concrete as it may be. But how different did it feel? It feels very vulnerable because, you know, especially in this play, it's just us and we're both here. And this character that we share is very vulnerable and part of it. So I guess in the difference of the ensemble work is that way, that sometimes you're walking a tight rope, you know, you don't know where it's gonna fall. And this piece is still molding itself for me, and I'm still discovering who we are in this play. So it does, in many ways it allows more space for exploration on stage, not during the process itself, but on stage it allows more than ensemble work does, because it's a free playground with ensemble. You have to listen to everything that everybody, you know, you stay tight. The shows that I do usually are very choreographed and very together, blend, like you said, with the team. And but here, there's still the same type of communication, really listening, you know, and discovering and being present with each other, playing off of each other. It does feel like a dance sometimes, where we go in and out in a cage. So in that way, it doesn't differ that much. But yeah, I mean, I don't know if I was articulated.
Do you mind if I have a part two? It's okay. During your process here, and when I would walk into the room, this room felt different than any of the other groups in Houston, which are usually ensemble groups. And I was very respectful of this space that you had created to do this work in. And I don't know you as well, Marissa, but I know Paula, and Paula was a different woman when I would walk in the room. I was afraid to talk to you. No, because you weren't you. And so I knew the work that you guys were doing was intense, and the way that you worked together during these 3 or 4 weeks that I've seen you with all the crazy schedules. It was amazing. It was just like all this subconscious stuff was going on, even when you were working, you would be sitting there, and you would be sitting there, but it's totally fucking working.
That's great.
You know, it was amazing. So I was feeling the progression. It was like I was walking into the case.
And I mean, it's good to hear that, because this play, I think, challenges me every day during performance and outside of performance in rehearsal room to find the sacred and the ritualness of it all. And it's something I'm still discovering, and when to tap into that, and when to ground it, and when to go ethereal. And that was definitely present in the rehearsal room.
Especially when in June we did a workshop that focused on movement,
mm-hmm.
some text, but it focused a lot on movement, and we would put that Greek music on and do these contact improvs, and we have our eyes closed, and I have the videos of these, and we're moving exactly the same way often. I mean, it is very much like dipping into the cave, dipping into dreams, you know, that's what the
I'd like to comment on the relevancy of this work. Today more than ever, it is essential for women to rediscover the sacred feminine.
Yes.
And so the work that you're doing is very, very important. I've spent time in Kenosis, and the Minoan civilization is based on partnership, is completely egalitarian. And I suggest that people read the chalice and the blade by the BMI so that they all get a sense of the true tradition that they're speaking of. And in Greece, there is a oracle Delphi. And when you go to the oracle Delphi, they tell you that this is an altar that belongs to Apollo. But in fact, Apollo murdered Venus, who was the original goddess of that. So when you talk about the Roman civilization, when you talk about the snake, it also relates back to the Judeo-Christian concept of finding the serpent evil for bringing knowledge. And essentially, that's what this is about, is the knowledge of the feminine.
That's
And as we embrace our problem, as we embrace our hat, what happened in this election could not have happened.
Yeah, because we can, yeah. There's two things that I learned, that sprang to me when you spoke. One is, in Crete, there are no poisonous snakes. So that snake goddess image is not an evil one. It is one of being rooted to the earth. And a friend of mine here connected me with somebody in Crete to help show me around and stuff like that, because I did the trip by myself. And I was saying, what do I bring back my friend who's from Crete? And he thought about it a long time. Herbs. That's what's valued. That was like the most important thing to bring back to his friend, for me to bring back to his friend, his herbs, the earth. And I mean, I'm so glad you said that. I didn't get that, because I think, crone means crown.
Absolutely,
right?
True. And what you pointed out in this pledge, I found utterly brilliant, was how patriarchy has controlled the feminine to be competitive. And that is the dance that you played in this play. The man sent the flowers to her younger self. So women are completely disenfranchised by their process of wisdom.
And my character completely rejects everything, you know, she's done that classical negating the feminine in order to be part of the culture, right? So, and it isn't until she makes this connection that she's able to give up the first one. So, thanks for
well, that rage and pain that you danced when she called you a hat was mind blowing. Because so many of your elders, such as myself, have gone through that experience of being incredibly gorgeous in their youth and then becoming, as you describe so perfectly, invisible. But here's my message.
I heard that from a lot of women I spoke to.
My message
is
about
invisibility,
use it.
Because you can see it. Ways that when you're being watched, you're aware of being watched, right? So, yeah.
Use it. And I'm really, you're the playwright.
Yeah.
That's the one little missing link that I didn't see communicating with. Just saying. I would like to, I know a play is always growing and changing.
Yeah.
So, my suggestion is a bit more of a solution would be helpful in this day and age. For
and I actually was going to talk to you about this because I did shoot, because the video has 5 more minutes of her going back to person that I've already shot. It's already just being put together because the video is also going to live as a short film. And at one point we thought tonally it wouldn't be right to put it because it's kind of madcap and crazy, but I've been thinking I want to put it in. Because she goes back to rehearsal as the crone and just kind of all hell breaks loose.
I think that's kind of brilliant. And I think that it, just in my little simple opinion, it requires it.
Okay.
I don't know about that, but that statement of embracing is required.
Yeah.
Because what you see here is an abandonment when she walks out. And I don't think that's what you meant at all. And it's not any other part of the play.
That's interesting that you see it as an abandonment. I see it differently. I see it as a letting go.
Yeah.
I don't need that anymore. That of coming into yourself and letting it go. And I think, I can't speak to this experience because clearly I haven't gone through it. And if anything, I'm on the very opposite end of it. But I think there is something exciting about theater and art in general, with leaving people to find their own resolution and seeing what it is, right? Whether for some people it will be abandonment, for some people it will be something completely different. resident and as an entrepreneur myself.
I also just want to give a reflection back. It felt like food. It felt like food.
Oh.
Like the food for the soul. And being an actor myself for many years, at moments I just felt like my heart was like, ah. Because you spoke to the pain of this woman and just the pain of aging. And it wasn't just being stuck in the pain, but I'm saying, I just want to share with you the resonance of this piece. And I really, spoke to me a lot. I was like, leaning forward, like, you know. But yet it's also so feminine and flowing and the beautiful, I don't want to say choreographed because it felt so organic. But the movements that you had with each other and mirroring each other, just so fluid.
Thank you. This is an amazing thing because it means a lot to me coming from you because I know.
Yeah, and I respected your work a long time. And just now as we were talking, I remember seeing a clip of you in a class doing video. That was...
Wow.
And you know, I was
Sophia.
I wanted to share, like, that was at the Performing Arts High School in New York, and the BBC came in to film it. Yes, and I would be in my bedroom in New York, and I would get, and this is so terrible for vegans, I apologize, but I would get, like, meat from the store and see what it felt like to kill the kid. I mean, I was so insanely in my youth of loving acting. But that piece transformed my life, doing and Medea
stayed with me. You were like, ah.
Yeah, no, that did trip. That's tripping. Well, I'm so grateful to be here today and to say congratulations for
yes.
not only being an actor, but creating this beautiful piece for us as women to get food that we need it right now so desperately. Things I didn't know. I felt like I was learning. I was like, really? That's what I need? Let me take out my phone and set that definition down.
If you want some books, both she and I can.
I've already exchanged cards. I mean, thank you so much, both of you, and your beautiful work.
Please tell your friends.
I will. I will post it.
Absolutely. Very, it's been a source, particularly, it's been a source leading up to, but then especially this week. I want to get everyone that I know.
Yes.
Of all ages, I think it's. Yeah, I think you're absolutely right. It speaks to the same thing that is available to us all.
It's essential. Yeah. Beyond the bill, it's essential. Women must speak. Women may not remain silent any longer in any way.
No,
they're not.
Grab the bowls.
I love that.
Just very little is known about the Elysian mysteries, but there
was based on these little figurines at one point towards the end where the initiate, the person going through the initiation swings. So we have a swing there. And I did find these two pillars. You know, nobody was in this area, and I walked around and just went in between. I was like, oh, here's where the swing was. You know?
So did you feel the sense of partnership when you were there? And NSS, did you feel that?
You were asking me?
Either of you?
I wasn't there.
Okay.
So I just went by myself.
Yes, you went by yourself, but did you feel that sense in that culture of egalitarian partnership?
Oh,
because there
absolutely.
Were no fortifications whatsoever for 2,000 years.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
So it was never matriarchal, it was always matriarchal. And there's a big difference.
Yes,
and that's the partnerships around.
Yeah, that's
so,
right.
I would love to think that. It's just brilliant. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Any other questions or thoughts?
I have a question, but I feel like I should know this, but the Elysian mysteries, the what is it?
It's pronounced, I've seen it spelled two different ways, but E-L-E. S-I-A-N.
Can you say one more time?
E-L-E-U-S-I-A-N. And then it's also spelled E-L-Y-S-I-A-N.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Sorry.
Okay. And do you have the recipe for the drink?
I do. No, but there was, that's a real drink. Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah.
That's a real drink. I did drink it, and it was like heaven on earth. It was ambrosia.
It was a living home. I love that it looks the gesture you make when you do taste it, because I have that moment of like, she really did taste it. I can see.
And it's not the tea that Pat makes.
Not that that's not the lecture.
It's a
hero
for
me. I had a comment to my question. The comment was,
I just found that picture. I love her.
Okay. And then Because I had her as an artist, you know, whatever. Then where did the portion come from?
That's actually Catalan.
From Catalan?
That's Catalan, which is where my ancestors are from.
I've never spoken
Catalan before, and so I wanted to have that experience.
Well, it was so delicious.
Oh,
I was wondering,
right.
Not knowing how it fit in, was really
nuts.
Because I was like, it was unexpected, and then it felt so ancestral.
Yeah.
But I could pinpoint it was that woman, that picture, where that catalog is from.
It's such a wild language. I think she played it. She had a friend that played it for us and recorded it. I'm a Portuguese speaker. Marissa speaks Spanish. And both of us were listening to that.
Almost.
The Greek was almost easier for us.
Oh, yeah, Catalan.
Oh, yeah. It was so like, wow, there's so many things in it, you know, and where I wanted to go. Spanish with it, then it there were these other sounds, you know.
So the incantations of you calling on your own personal ancestors didn't hurt. I could feel that infusing it, which is quite fabulous.
Yeah, they're always nice.
Yeah. Bless you.